We will treat you equally, and you are free to create your own best life. This was a sentence that my parents were saying to me while I was growing up. One of the most important lessons in life I learned at home. And this is how I learned about equality and freedom. I was born in 1988 as the first child in the family, literally first child. So I was first from my mother's side, I was first from my father's side, and I became a real small queen, inflamed with love. I had all the attention in the world. But soon, this situation changed. After 2.5 years, my brother, Alexander Tsako, was born, and he was born with Down syndrome. Soon after, 13 months later, we received another baby. My baby boy, Boyan, was born, another brother with typical development without any disability. And having a child with Down syndrome in your family, it is really easy to learn about diversity and to celebrate it, to celebrate the differences between people. So me and my brothers were raising, were growing in the same spirit, sharing the same values. And maybe that's why I become part of so many different NGOs, initiatives. I learn about human rights, about how to protest, how to fight, how to advocate. And also, my brother Alexander, the one with Down syndrome, was following my steps. So he became a highly functional unit in the society. He became a pioneer in so many different areas. Imagine, he is the first university student with Down syndrome in our country. And he became super independent and self-confident. He's a dreamer, he talks a lot, and one day he came to us and said, "Look guys, I have really important thing to talk about." And I was like, "Yeah, okay, let's talk." He saw a TV show, and in that TV show there was another boy with Down syndrome, and the boy was hosting his own radio show. And Tsako was, "I will do the same." And at the time, I had my own radio show, Sexy Hood. We hosted with a couple of teammates. We were talking about sexual and reproductive health, rights, etc. And I was like, okay, I'm the role model here, and you want to do your own show? It's kind of a no-no, no way. And at that time, I didn't believe in my brother. And what do you think? Did he manage to have his own show? If yes, please raise your hand. Oh, of course, he managed it. Fourth year in a row, he is having his own show. I'm Tsako, yes, I'm Tsako, on the online radio, and it's the first show ever hosted by a person with Down syndrome in my country. And this was just the beginning of a wonderful journey. The next thing I know was me and Tsako standing at the headquarters of the United Nations in New York, delivering a speech for the World Down Syndrome Day 2016. Imagine, 25-year-old boy from a small country sharing messages for inclusion with the world. And at that time, it was a completely different story. I have zero skepticism that things will work out. And even from the beginning, I knew that Tsako will be selected. And yes, he got selected. It was crazy time, it was wonderful time. We haven't much money to go to New York, you know, it's kind of a costly, but we managed to raise the money in less than a week time. And we were there, standing and speaking in front of the UN. Actually, Tsako was speaking, I was just the logistic and I was doing the translation. But the bottom line is that we managed it. And the thing is that I truly believed in my brother in that time. So my message is that we have to have faith. I have faith in people, in changes, in the human potential. Next thing, it's Ilina. Please meet Ilina. Actually, I meet her. I met her a year ago on one workshop. I was hosting a workshop for idea generation, and there she was. She was talking, asking so many questions, and we stayed after the workshop, and she shared her story with me. So basically, in that time, Ilina was also 25, as Tsako was 25 when he was delivering the speech in the UN, and she started her career as a lawyer. But she felt that this is not really her dream, that she wanted to create different kind of an impact, and as she was saying, not just to implement the laws, but to change them and to change the system. And she got me here. We clicked, and afterwards we become really good friends. So now Ilina is one of the biggest promoters of social entrepreneurship in the region. She is a co-founder of her own business and a really dear friend of mine. So what happened with Ilina in 1 year? So basically, first, she quit her job. Then she won the Social Impact Award, one of the programs that I run. And then she established her own business called Create or Sozdati. Sozdati actually, at the moment, serves as a regional platform for entrepreneurship support, where all people that do handmade and homemade products are drawing their efforts. So basically, crafters with many different backgrounds, such as victims of domestic violence, people with disability, can just transform their creative hobbies into their real careers. And that's what Elena is doing at the moment. And if you open this platform, you will find many interesting e-shops. And for me, and it's directly correlated with my first story, the most interesting is the shop of Betka Pletka. Betka is knitting. So who is Betka? Yeah, Betka Pletka, very interesting name. So who is Betty now? Betty is another lady with Down syndrome who is super skillful at knitting, and she produces handmade jewelry. So basically, Elena helps Betty to establish her business. Elena believes in Betty, and Betty believes in Elena. And they really become good friends, so they do so many different activities together. They do a lot of volunteering jobs, such as a couple of weeks ago, I also joined them. They were cooking for one informal initiative called Red with a Meal, and they were cooking for the homeless people in Skopje. So they really do a lot of things together. And my point is that these are really small steps, but small steps that can dramatically change the society and the system. The bottom line here, again, is faith. And faith is the thing that maybe your heart really knows, and sometimes your rational mind just fails to understand the thing, but it's there. Faith in people, in changes, in dreams, in human potential. And how I end up knowing all these amazing people is through my passion for social entrepreneurship. I felt that the world is changing, and I guess you will all agree with me that the world is changing. And I felt that we are really less tolerant. We are super intolerant to injustice, to wars, to everything. And I feel the eagerness that we can change the situation. So basically, I started working for an organization called Mladi Info that actually serves to help young people. And they also are conducting different kinds of programs for youngsters, such as the Social Impact Award, the program I already mentioned to you. And if we talk about social entrepreneurship, it's a pretty new concept, especially in this part of the region, and then we'll face with many, many different obstacles, problems, and challenges. So basically, I can take my country as an example, and there are many research in this regards. First, if we talk the legislation, we don't have such a good legislation. If we talk about stakeholders, the connection between them are sometimes loose. If we talk about ventures, we talk about early stage ventures, we talk about micro enterprises. So there are many, 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 many problems. There are lack of educational opportunities, but on the other hand, this leaves us space to work on these problems and to overcome these problems as Betty and Elena are doing at the moment. So basically that's why afterwards we create the Social Impact Lab where we grow ideas. We start with young entrepreneurs, and not only young, entrepreneurs in general, jointly detecting the social challenges that they are passionate about. Then we build a business model that is suitable for their social challenge. And then this leaves a sustainability on the system on the long run. And if we talk about social business, we can incorporate the social business in many different areas. We can incorporate the social business in every part of our living. So basically here we can talk about human rights, we can talk about empowerment, we can talk about employability, about so-called, I hate the word, vulnerable, marginalized group of people, such as people with Down syndrome, etc. So we can incorporate the business in many, many, many areas. But the bottom line here, again, it's faith. If we work with people, we have to believe in those people. We have to believe that the change will come. We have to believe in their dreams, and we have to believe in their potential. And that was the lesson that I learned. If I want to support personal growth, if I want to help people, the biggest assistance I can offer is the faith. So my question to you now would be, what is the next step you will do to change the world? A small step. Elena, Tsako, Betty, they all make me sparkle. Throughout the way, I met a lot of people that fill me with positive energy, a lot of people that will stay in my heart and mind forever, joyful moments. So just think about the question and see who is your next step. And let's start now. Let's do some small action. Basically, take your phones, devices, notepads, whatever you have. Use the hashtag #IHaveFaithThat. Finish the sentence and post it on your social media. Let's see what is going to happen. My name is Marija Matovska. My friends sometimes call me, joke with me, calling me Facebook because I do a lot of connections between people. These were my three stories, and one word that described them all starts on F. It's not Facebook, but it's fate. Thank you very much.